So intermittent fasting, the big one. So intermittent fasting, there are six different, you know, types of intermittent fasting. So when people tell me, oh, I'm intermittent fasting now, I always say, which one, which type? And then they say, what do you mean? Like, because they, I guess, haven't realized that there are all of these different ways. So it really is just a broad term for alternate periods where you eat and then fast. So, or what I like to call living your life and then going to sleep like a human, normal person, and then waking up and trying, you know, trying the next day. So benefit claims are vast. So weight loss, you decrease insulin levels, you can improve your insulin sensitivity, improve blood pressure, decrease inflammation, curb your appetite, and really help improve your lipid profile, which would be your triglycerides and your cholesterol, like your LDL cholesterol and your HDL cholesterol, which would be your healthy cholesterol. So types of intermittent fasting, these are the six types. I'm going to go into each one after this. So the 16-8 method, the 5-2 diet, the eat, stop, eat, the alternate day fasting, which is pretty self-explanatory, the warrior diet, and then the spontaneous meal skipping, which is exactly what it sounds like. So first, the 16-8 method. Basically, what the recommendation is, the parameters of this diet is you eat, you fast 14 to 16 hours a day and then restrict your eating window to 8 to 10 hours a day. So what that means is you might skip breakfast. So you have your last meal in the evening around 7, 8 at night, and then you wouldn't eat again until the next day, like midday. So this is a pretty common method. A lot of people do this. They don't, and which for, you know, when I hear about this, I always say, oh, so you just don't eat breakfast, because that's kind of what this is. So during the fasting periods, you can drink water, coffee, and anything that is non-caloric you can drink. You just can't drink a sugary beverage. And if you're drinking coffee, you can put an artificial sweetener, you can't add sugar, you can't add milk, you can't add any of those things. The 5-2 diet is you would eat normally 5 days a week, and then 2 days a week you would fast. So on those fasting days, you would restrict your calorie intake to about 500 or 600 calories a day. And the recommendation is for women 500 calories, men 600 calories, but I roll my eyes because that really doesn't take into account the size of people. So if you are a 6-foot female, then you probably, you know, would benefit from a higher calorie diet on the days that you're fasting. So the eat, stop, eat is basically you're going to do a 24-hour day fast 1 to 2 times a week. So you're going to fast from dinner to dinner, whatever. If your lifestyle is that you're, a lot of people like to do this when they're sleeping. So they try to do it, you know, they'll eat dinner or they'll eat breakfast and they'll fast all day. Then they'll eat breakfast the next day or however people want to do it. You know, it doesn't, a lot of people that I know have tried this and it has never really lasted long. But there are studies on this, so we don't really know actual research on this. Same thing is you can still drink the water, the coffee, the non-caloric beverages, but you can absolutely not eat any solids while you're doing this on the days you fast. Alternate day fasting is basically you're going to fast every other day. So what that means is you're going to either completely fast every other day or have a very minimal caloric intake of about, you know, 500 calories and nothing more than that. So that is maybe one of the more restrictive, just because every other day, what it sometimes does is it really pushes people to eat more on the days that they're eating. And so then the days they are like, oh, I only have to get through like one day. So sort of if you average it for a week, you're probably consuming the same amount of calories. The warrior diet is you fast during the day and then you eat a huge meal at night. I know a number of people who just sort of eat like this anyway. So now there's actually a name for it. So some people, so what it means is you can eat small amounts of some raw fruits and vegetables during the day. You have one meal at night. And then you're eating at night really within a 4-hour window. So it's not like you're eating when you get home from work and then you have a snack before bed. It's just, you know, like, boom, there's a small period defined of when you can eat. Spontaneous meal skipping is exactly what it sounds like. You're just gonna skip a meal when it's convenient. Like you're tired, you don't wanna eat dinner, you don't wanna cook dinner, you forgot to bring something home, you have no food at home, and instead of ordering out, like just go to bed or just don't eat and have some water. So that's really, it's more natural way of fasting. It's a little bit what I call common sense fasting. You just don't have to make a big deal about it. You could just sort of do it as you find it to be convenient. So the bottom line with the intermittent fasting is a lot of people can get really good results, but you really still need to remember that on the days or the time periods that you're eating, you need to eat healthy foods. It's not really recommended. It's not going to bode well for you health-wise or necessarily weight-wise if you were just binging on junk foods during those times, because the junk foods are going to make you want to eat. It's going to be hard to adhere to the fasting when you're eating junk during the times you can eat. So, and also, you know, I know a bunch of people who do some form of intermittent fasting and they'll just eat like a bowl of pasta and then they're like, I'm really starving. And so it's just not, it's filling temporarily, but you're not getting a good nutritional profile when you are eating those days. It's not for everyone, intermittent fasting. It's really hard to sustain. You know, if you have low blood sugar or you have diabetes, it's not necessarily recommended for health purposes to be fasting for long periods of time. So just, you know, you never want to start anything without discussing it with, you know, a healthcare provider.